The National Museum, Národní muzeum, in Prague occupies two magnificent buildings at the top of Wenceslas Square. It is the oldest and largest museum in the country. The museum's primary focus is the nature and history of the Czech Republic. But it also holds temporary exhibitions on a range of subjects of international significance, from ancient Egypt to space. The main building is the historical building of the National Museum, a monumental neo-Renaissance structure set in a commanding position at the head of Wenceslas Square. This building boasts a grand entrance hall with sweeping staircases, intricate stonework and beautiful ceiling frescoes. The exhibition rooms, which lead off the entrance hall, house a stunning natural history collection, featuring fossils, rocks, minerals, meteorites, a huge skeleton of a fin whale, and stuffed and life-size models of animals and birds. Some are prehistoric and extinct, such as a woolly mammoth. Other rooms house historical exhibitions, which cover the history of Prague and the Czech lands from the 8th century through to the present day. It is a dramatic story, spanning the foundation of Prague, Empire, the World Wars, and Nazi and communist occupations. The historical building also hosts temporary exhibitions. We list the main ones in Prague events. One final attraction of the historical building is the dome. Visitors can pay 50 CZK to ride the lift up to it, from where there are terrific views over Wenceslas Square and across the city as far as Prague Castle. The historical building of the National Museum was constructed between 1818 and 1891 on the site of the former horse gate. Wenceslas Square once served as Prague's main horse market. It was designed by Joseph Schultz as an architectural symbol of the Czech National Revival. Nowadays, the National Museum contains millions of museum items. Its collections include Czech and foreign material testimonies to the development of nature and history. Within the frame of a uniquely large number of long-term and temporary exhibitions, one can learn, among other things, about geology, paleontology, zoology, anthropology, and prehistory. The National Museum also keeps the Czech historical book stock and its representatives pursue publication, educational, and lecturing activities. The reconstruction of the historical building of the National Museum, which witnessed the essential milestones of Czech modern history. The works performed on the historical building of the National Museum include extensive construction works, the repairs of the facade, activities of the renovators on the outdoor decorations and in the building interiors, building the connection hall between the historical and new building. In October 2018, the repaired building shall host the Czech-Slovakian exhibition, Slovakian-Czech exhibition prepared for the 100 years anniversary of Czechoslovakian Republic and 200 years from the establishment of the National Museum. The reconstruction works are intensively in progress. Specifically, Prakom performed a professional reconstruction of the existing carpenter sub-construction of the stiffening trusses and vertical bars in 2017. Bohemitagent was successfully used for the works. The National Museum building was completed in 1891 according to the design of architect Joseph Schultz. It was repeatedly and several damaged during time. In 1945 it was damaged by German bomb, in 1968 it became a target of bullets from Soviet soldiers, and in the 70s the statics was damaged during the construction of Prague Underground. The general supplier of the reconstruction is the association MPI National Museum. The aim of the reconstruction is to save this significant national cultural monument, and also to turn it into a modern museum premise. During the reconstruction of the main building, some of the exhibits are displayed in other national museum buildings, as part of temporary exhibitions. The historically and architecturally valuable building had been damaged most of all by two military attacks, in 1945 and in 1968. At the end of World War II, during the Prague Uprising, May 1945, the building was hit by an aerial bomb. And in 1968, when the occupation, one of the darkest eras in Bohemian history, started, the Soviet military armed vehicles drove onto Wenceslas Square. They shot at the National Museum, thinking it was the Czech radio building. Also, the National Museum building's statics were damaged during the construction of the Prague Metro A line in the 70s of the last century. The Czech National Museum consists of five specialized, professionally autonomous institutions: the Museum of Natural Science, Prírodovědecké muzeum, the Historical Museum, Historic Museum, the Naprostek Museum of Asia, African, and American Cultures, Naprostkovo Muzeum Mishijskaik, Afrikacha Amerikacha Kultur, the National Museum Library, Nyhovna Narodnaya Muzea, and the Museum of Czech Music, České Muzeum Hubby. The National Museum unites 16 objects and expositions in the Czech Republic. Let us mention the most important Prague ones. The most significant one is the currently closed main historical building on the top of Wenceslas Square. This neo-Renaissance building amazes with its decorations, created by some of the most renowned Czech artists, painters and sculptors, such as Vojta Kajnáš, also the author of the famous curtain of the Prague National Theatre. There are 72 names from Czech history written in gold on the facade of the building, too. The National Museum New Building at Vinohradská Street, Prague 1, is another very important building under the National Museum jurisdiction. The former seat of the Radio Free Europe was transferred under the jurisdiction of the National Museum in 2009. Nowadays it hosts, among other things, a long-term exhibition, Noah's Ark, focusing on animals that live or used to live on our planet.